सिस्टम शक्तिं च शंच व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दं शिष्यं फॉरगॉट द फर्स्ट ईयर नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो मद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यो सर्वोपप्लवित प्रज्ञानगण प्रत्यकर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरी सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् लुकिंग एट लक्षण ऑफ अध्यास. सो हियर अध्यास हैज बीन मेंशन्ड इन दी भाष्य एज व्हाट स्मृति रूप परत्र पूर्व दृष्टावभास स्मर्यते इति स्मृति ही दैट विल मेक इट अर्थाध्यास. सो अवभास ऑफ समथिंग विच डज नॉट बिलोंग. नाउ दिस अवभास इज व्हाट In English, last time I may have said cognition. So that will make it jnanadhyasa. And if you say it is cognized, that which is cognized, then it will become arthadhyasa. Both are adhyasta. There is a jnanadhyasa as well as arthadhyasa. So in this shukti rajata stala, rajata is adhyasta, is an adhyasa. It is an avabhasa of something which is purvadrushta. पूर्वदृष्ट सत्यरजत वेर परत्र नॉट इन दैट प्लेस नॉट इन दैट काल ऑल्सो एल्सवे परत्र. सो दैट इज अध्यास. सो अवभास हैज अ घंज प्रत्यय. दैट घंज प्रत्यय कैन बी भावे ऑल्सो एंड कर्मणि ऑल्सो. भावे विल गिव यू ज्ञानाध्यास कॉग्निशन एंड कर्मणि घई विल गिव यू अर्थाध्यास. सो हियर इन द टीका वी आर लुकिंग एट व्हाट इज दिस डिस्कशन राइट नाउ एज टू आह. द पूर्ववादी इज आस्किंग वेदर इट इज दिस अध्यास. व्हाट इज द लक्षण ऑफ अध्यास. को आह कोयम अध्यासो नामेति. That ah, whether it is vada, jalpa or vitanda. So in the tika, it is said vadi prativadibhyam guru shishyabhyam paksha pratipaksha parigrahena kriyamana artha niranaya avasana. Vada katha, this is vada. Why? Because this ah can also be seen as shishya's question. It is a very valid question asking a lakshana. Is a very valid question. So it can be considered as a vada katha, need not be jalpa or vitanda. Since the vadi and prativadi, those who are having a dialectic, who are those guru shishya, like in the case of Gita also. Similarly, here also that can be seen, paksha pratipaksha parigrahena, looking at each other's perspective. The questioning need not be to offend the other, it can be to learn also. Therefore, this ah can be a shishya's question. Therefore, it is a vada katha. Kriyamana artha nirnaya avasana. The conclusion will be in the culmination will be in the artha nirnaya. It will be in the conclusion of the subject of discussion. therefore this is vadakatha tasyaha bhava tattvam. So that is vadakatha, and therefore this is tadnyapanartham ityartha. So that is the what we saw in the Ratnaprabha also last time. It can be one of these, and right now we can take it as vada. This was from the Purvapakshi's question as to why it is not taken as an akshepa. So earlier it was taken as every Purvapaksha was taken as akshepa, whereas here this kim shabda koyam ahader koyam, that can be seen as Shishya's question also. That is the answer given. Why not here? So here it can be Shishya's question. It is a prashna. Okay. Vishayadi siddhihetvadhyasa siddhihetubhutani yani lakshana sambhavana pramanani tat pratipadaka bhashya vibhagam ah. Now, since the question has come up, so adhyasa lakshana has to be looked at. Adhyasa being possible, sambhavana is to be looked at, and what is the pramana for that? That is also to be seen. Therefore, lakshana sambhavana pramanani yani, which are what? Vishaya siddhi, vishayadi siddhi, vishaya prayojana ityadi anubandha chaturtaya siddhi, hetva siddhi, hetu adhyasa, the hetu adhyasa siddhi hetu bhutani, those will be established when their hetu adhyasa is established, and there while we need lakshana, sambhavana and pramana for adhyasa. Once pramana shows that adhyasa is possible, what kind of adhyasa? That which is shown with lakshana, then it will become a hetu for the vishaya, because adhyastha vishaya, vishaya meaning the object and vishaya meaning the subject also. So subject matter vishaya, because the vishaya prapancha is adhyastha, therefore the jnanena moksha aikya jnanena moksha will be possible, therefore prayojana will be possible, and that is a vishayadi siddhi. Vishayadi siddhi is possible due to what hetu? Adhyasa siddhi. And adhyasa siddhi hetu, how will adhyasa be established? For that hetu bhutani are lakshana sambhavana and pramana. Therefore, tat is lakshana sambhavana pramanani pratipadaka bhashya vibhagam. So, lakshana sambhavana pramana pratipadaka bhashya vibhagam aha ityadi. So, Ratna Prabhakar also is looking into division of the bhashya, the sections of the bhashya which deal with lakshana, sambhavana and pramana. So, he is giving the sections there aha ityadi. Ratna Prabha, katham punaha pratyagatmani ityataha. Ityatah prag. So katham punaha, starting with this katham punaha, which is going to come up in the bhashya, katham punaha pratyagatmani ityatah prag adhyasa lakshana param bhashyam. So lakshana is being dealt with from uchyate onwards till the section where katham punaha pratyagatmani. This is a question by a Purvapaksha. Everything before that is lakshana param. It is committed to showing the lakshana of adhyasa in the adhyasa bhashya. Further, tad arabhya beginning with this katham puna ityadi sambhavana param. It is going to discuss the sambhavana of adhyasa possibility. Tam etam avidyakhyam ityarabhya. Till when? Till tam etam avidyakhyam in the bhashya. The section is sambhavana param, and from there onwards ityarabhya sarvaloka pratyaksha ityantam pramana param iti vibhaga, and the pramana for that is in the section of the bhashya between tametam avidyakhyam ityarabhya, from there to sarvaloka pratyaksha. So you can look up the section. I don't want to go across pages or even open Advaita Sharada right now, so we'll see when we land there as to what the section is talking about. Lakshanama, then what is the lakshanam? This is the vibhaga in the bhashya. So initially there is a lakshana given, definition. What is the lakshana of adhyasa? Uchyate smriti rupa iti. Smriti rupa, which we saw in the last part. Smriyate iti smritihi. अध्यास इति अनुषंग वाई दिस इज नीडेड सो टीकाकार सीज टीका लक्षणमिति स्वरूप लक्षण व्यावर्तक लक्षण चेत्याह सो लक्षण जनरली देयर इज अ डिफरेंस मेड बिटवीन विशेषण एंड अ नॉन विशेषण सो सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म इफ यू लुक एट चैत्रीय उपनिषद मंत्र सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म देयर भगवान भाष्यकार सेज दैट सत्यम ज्ञानम एंड अनंतम आर नॉट विशेषणास ऑफ ब्रह्म शब्द बट स्टिल सत्यम ब्रह्म ज्ञानम ब्रह्म अनंतम ब्रह्म व्हेन यू से दे अपीयर लाइक विशेषण जस्ट लाइक वीरो रामः सो वीरः रामः सो वीरः रामः देयर वीरः इज विशेषण फॉर राम हाउ सो और इन नीलम उत्पलम द एग्जांपल टेकन देयर इज नीलम उत्पलम लेट्स गो टू द स्टैंडर्ड एग्जांपल ऑफ द भाष्य इटसेल्फ नीलम उत्पलम Because we don't want to talk about Veera Rama, we'll need another Rama to differentiate this Rama from that can be Parshurama. Parshurama is also Veera. You can talk about Balarama, then Balarama is also Veera. Therefore, let's look at Neelam Utpalam. The Utpala can be seen as a lotus or even a lily elsewhere, but Utpalam is a lotus now. So Neelam is Visheshana to Utpala. Why? Because there are other kinds of Utpala also. There is also Rakta Utpala. So to differentiate between the red lotus and the blue lotus, the blue is an adjective added to the word lotus. So it will help you differentiate from the other. Itara Vyavartakam Visheshanam there. Visheshana is Itara Vyavartaka. It helps you differentiate the substantive from the others. That's an adjective. Visheshya is separated from the others. So this is that kind of lotus which is not red, not white, not anything else but only blue. Therefore it is a blue lotus, it is Neelam Utpalam. Similarly, you know, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, can Satyam Brahma show you that it is that kind of Brahma which is different from non-Satya Brahma? It is not because there is no other Brahma. Therefore, this is not a Itara Vyavartaka. It is Lakshana Param. So the Shabda, Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, all these Padas are Lakshana of Brahma. They are not Visheshanas of Brahma. So wherever there is Itara Vyavartakatvam, there it is seen as Visheshana, but Brahma is one without a second. There is no Abrahma also really. So you don't need to separate out Brahma from Abrahma. But what can be seen there is Vyavartakattvam there also. In Lakshana also. As to Satya shows that it is not Asat. Jnana shows that it is not Jada. Jnana means Chit. Chetana. So it is not Achetana. It is not Ajada. It is not Jada. And Ananta shows that it is not Antavat. So there is some kind of a Vyavartakatam also. But then it is predominantly a Lakshana showing what Brahma is. To help us understand what is Brahma. Similarly here in this Lakshana, what Lakshana is being talked about? There Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is not Tatastha Lakshana also. It is Swarupa Lakshana. And it is not Vyavartaka really. So it is not a Visheshana there. Satyam Brahma, Jnanam Brahma, Anantam Brahma. Whereas the Tatastha Lakshana of Brahma is Jagat Karana Brahma. Which is the first sutra in Brahma Sutra. Second sutra really. First sutra is Athato Brahma Jidnyasa. And then the Jagat Karana being Brahma is a Tatastha Lakshana. Because Brahma cannot be Jagat Karana, it is Nirguna. Karanattvam cannot be a Dharma in Brahma. The simplest refutation by Tarka, by Nyaya. Because being a न्याय प्रस्थान. सो हियर स्वरूप लक्षण ऑफ ब्रह्म शुड बी सीन एज सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म. कमिंग बैक टू अध्यास, व्हाट इज द लक्षण ऑफ अध्यास, विच लक्षण इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट. सो इसे स्वरूप लक्षण. फर्दर व्हाट, व्यावर्तक लक्षण च, दी लक्षण इज ऑल्सो व्यावर्तक. इट विल डिफरेंशिएट फ्रॉम व्हाट इज नॉट अध्यास, बिकॉज नॉन अध्यास इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. इफ यू टेक व्यावहारिक शुक्ति का, दैट हैज टू बी डिफरेंशिएटेड फ्रॉम दी अध्यास विच इज रजत, प्रातिभासिक रजत. सो अध्यास लक्षण शुड बी सच दैट इट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली टू प्रातिभासिक पदार्थस एंड ज्ञान ऑल्सो एंड नॉट दी अदर. देयरफॉर इट इज व्यावर्तक ऑल्सो. स्वरूप लक्षण व्यावर्त लक्षण च आह इत्यर्थः. ननु लक्षणवाक्ये लक्ष्याभिधायिनः पदस्य अभावात्, जी लक्षण इज ऑफ अध्यास, दिस इज व्हाट यू आर सेइंग. व्हाट इज दी भाष्य सेइंग, स्मृति रूप ऑफ परत्र पूर्व दृष्टावभासः. सो द पूर्व पक्षी इज आस्किंग अ वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन. देर इज नो वर्ड देर एज टू दैट इज अध्यास. However, it is an answer to koyam adhyaso rameti. So, adhyasa word, anavritti should be there. If someone asks you, what's your name? You say, Devadatta. You don't say, always end up saying, oh, my name is Devadatta. Children do that when they are learning the language. But once you have learned the language, someone asks you a question, you don't use all the words as a filler there. You don't complete the sentence using all the words which have been used in the question. It's not an exam paper. So you answer saying that Devadatta. So Devadatta, my name is Devadatta is a sentence that you hardly hear. But Anuvritti is there to complete the Vakya proper. Similarly here Adhyasa, Anuvritti should be there. So the question is, Nanu Lakshana Vakya Lakshavidhayinaha Padasya Kasya Adhyasasya Adhyasa Iti Padasya Abhavat Sakangsha Vachanam Arthakam इत्याशंक्य वाक्यं पूरयति. सो देयर इज आकांक्षा एज टू स्मृति रूप परत्र पूर्वदृष्ट अवभास इज व्हाट भवति, किं भवति. सो अध्यासः भवति, वाक्यं पूरयति अध्यास इति. सो अध्यास इति अनुषंग द अनुवृत्ति ऑफ अध्यास शुड बी एडेड. सो द सेंटेंस शुड बी कंप्लीटेड एज एडिंग अध्यास अध्यास. Just like you add tinganta, bhavati, asti, vartate, etc. That is Ratna Prabha there. Further, atra, tika, let's look at tika. Prashna vakya sthitasya adhyasa padasya anushanga kartavya ityartha. So anushanga of what? Of adhyasa. Where is that adhyasa? It is there in the prashna vakya itself. Anyway, it is clear. Niradishthana bhranti nirasartham paratra. इत्युक्ते अर्थात परस्य अवभासता सिद्धा इत्यभिप्रेत्य अवभास इत्युक्तम्. नाउ द लक्षण, व्हाट इज द लक्षण, स्मृति रूप परत्र पूर्व दृष्टावभास इज व्हाट इज मेंशन्ड इन द भाष्य. रत्न प्रभाकर सेज, रत्न प्रभा, अत्र परत्र अवभास इत्येव लक्षणम्. द डेफिनेशन लक्षण इज व्हाट, नॉट स्मृति रूप परत्र पूर्व दृष्टावभास. द एंटायर थिंग इज नॉट अ लक्षण. Although Bhagavan Bhashyakara is saying that for clarity, the Lakshana is what? Paratra Avabhasaha. Adhyasaha. Adhyasa is Paratra Avabhasaha. Then what about the other two words? Smriti Rupa and Puro Drushta. Shishtam Padadvayam Tad Upapadanartham. Pratipadanartham. It is only to explain what is Paratra and Avabhasa. So, Bhashya can have a gloss on Bhashya words itself. There can be an elaboration of Bhashya words. Similarly, here when Lakshana is given, what is this Lakshana? With the Lakshana word, the Pada in the Lakshana can also be elaborated. Therefore, Lakshana is only Paratra Avabhasaha Adhyasaha. Paratra Avabhasattvam अध्यासस्य लक्षणम्. देन स्मृति रूपः, एंड पूर्व दृष्टावभासा आर एलोबरेटिंग दीज टू वर्ड्स. द अदर टू वर्ड्स आर एलोबरेटिंग दीज टू वर्ड्स. विच वर्ड इज एलोबरेटिंग वॉट? सो तथा ही हाउ सो स्मृति रूपा इज एन एलोबरेशन एंड पूर्व दृष्टा इज एन एलोबरेशन. तथा ही अवभास्यति इति अवभासः कर्मणि घञ् अवभास्यते अर्थाध्यास. अवभास्यते इति अवभासः, दैट विच इज कॉग्नाइज इज कॉल्ड एज अवभासः. व्हाट इज दैट? रजतादि अर्थ अर्थाध्यास. द सिल्वर विच इज कॉग्नाइज्ड इज अध्यास. वेर इज इट कॉग्नाइज्ड? परत्र शुक्तिकादौ. सो तस्य अयोग्यम अधिकरणम परत्र पदार्थः. दि शुक्तिका इज अयोग्य अधिकरण. इन दैट अधिकरण ऑफ शुक्ति, इन द लोकस ऑफ शुक्ति, सिल्वर इज कॉग्नाइज. सो सिल्वर इज अवभासः अर्थ, वेर एज अधिष्ठान अधिकरण, अधिष्ठान इंस्टेड ऑफ अधिष्ठान अधिकरण, अधिकरण द लोकस वेर इट इज सीन, द सिल्वर इज सीन इज शुक्ति. The shell, that shell is paratra. So purva drishta, we'll come to purva drishta later. In the tika, prashna vakya sitas, not niradishthana bhranti nirasartham. Bhranti will need an adishthana. If the avabhasa is paratra, where it doesn't belong, that means it is not yatharth jnana, it is a bhranti, that is adhyasa. And can that adhyasa take place anywhere without an adhisthana, without an adhikarana also? Niradhisthana bhranti nirasartham, there is no possibility of seeing something in that which doesn't exist. You cannot have shunyavada. Shunyavada is not possible at all. Shunyavada is no vada really. The person who is giving that vada himself is non-existent as per his own philosophy. As per this Nastika darshana of shunyavada, Bauddha mata, everything is an appearance in nothing. Nothing exists. If nothing exists, who is making this argument? That entity doesn't exist. So how can you discuss with someone when that someone does not exist? Who says that you also do not exist? Whereas you are very clear that I exist. And the person who knows that he exists is making a claim that I do not exist. It is like saying the tongue being there, it is not there. So someone says, I do not have a tongue. So that statement, it cannot be true. If he is saying that I do not have a tongue, then that itself shows that there is a tongue. So shunyavada is a bogus vada really. So niradishthana bhranti is not possible. Niradishthana bhranti nirasartam paratra ityuktam. So paratra has been mentioned, avabhasaha. अवभास्यते इति अवभासः, दैट विच अपीयर्स, दैट विच इज कॉग्नाइज्ड, इट्स एन ऑब्जेक्ट. वेर इज इट कॉग्नाइज्ड? इट हैज टू बी कॉग्नाइज्ड समवेयर. देयरफॉर अधिकरण इज नीडेड. इट इज नॉट कॉग्नाइज्ड इन शून्य, इट इज कॉग्नाइज्ड इन सम अधिष्ठान. नाउ दैट अधिष्ठान इन प्रातिभासिक सत्ता इज व्यावहारिक, प्रातिभासिक अर्थ इज कॉग्नाइज्ड, इट इज इन व्यावहारिक लोकस. Therefore, paratra, as you mentioned, this paratra, where the silver should be, where it really exists, rutam, as a fact in the apana, apanastha rajatam satyam, vyavaharika satyam, satya, it has vyavaharika satyatva. There, the adhikarana is where, adhikarana is where it can be seen. But here there is an adhikarana where it cannot be seen. It should not be seen. Not cannot, it should not be seen. That is the ayogyata. Ayogyam adhikaranam. In the Ratna Prabha, adhikarana is what? It is ayogya, therefore it is paratra. It is mentioned as paratra. Whereas apadastha rajatam is not paratra. Yogyatvam is there. So that is going to be discussed next. Niradishthana bhranti nirasartham in the tika paratra ityukte arthat parasya avabhasata siddha ityabhipretya avabhasa ityuktam. So paratra is mentioned to cover the niradishthana bhranti nirasa. You cannot have bhranti without an adhikarana which is existent, which has a higher level of reality than the adhyastha, aropya. But when paratra is mentioned, then you avabhasa, why do you need there? That shows that you are seeing something in that place where it doesn't belong. Therefore, avabhasa is mentioned. Tad upapadanartham, its elaboration is being done. So for that purpose of elaboration, the other two words have been filled in the bhashya. Lakshana upapadanartham ityartha. Elaborate, to elaborate what? Tat means lakshana. To elaborate the very definition which is paratra avabhasa, that much only. Smriti Rupa and Purvadrushta is an elaboration. Paratra padatatpariyena lakshana pravishtam yat swasamsurujya manatva visheshanam tadupapadanartham padadvayam bhavati na lakshana pravishtam iti bhavaha. So these two words, Smriti Rupa and Purvadrushta, these are the words which are elaborating the lakshana paratra avabhasa. They do not belong in the lakshana itself. So lakshana pravishta shabdas they aren't, padas they aren't. So paratra padatatparina lakshana pravishtam yat, what is there? Swasamsrujya manatva visheshanam, which is connected. So swa is rajata, rajata samsrujya manatva visheshanam. We'll see that here in the elaboration in the Ratna Prabha. We'll come back to this sentence. In Tatahi, what is said is avabhasyati iti avabhasa rajatadhyartha tasya ayogyam adhikaranam paratra padartha adhikaranasya ayogyatvam aropya atyantabhavatvam tadvatvam va. There is a question here, but then moving a little ahead, we'll come back to this also. Tathacha ekavachina swasamsrujyamane swatyantabhavati avabhasyatvam adhyastatvam ityartha. So what is the lakshana? Lakshana is ekavachhedina swasamsrujyamane. That swasamsrujyamane, swa is rajata. Rajata samsrujyamane sati. In the adhikarana, rajata has samsarga. Sambandha is there. Rajata has to have sambandha with shuktika. Where is the rajata darshana? So rajata avabhasa is there where? In shuktika stala. So that shukti stala where you see that shukti is there. There you see rajata. Then rajata is somehow connected with the adhikarana. You have seen samsarga adhyasa earlier. So swa samsurjyamane sati. Swa atyanta bhavati avabhasyatvam. Where it isn't there? Atyanta bhava swa rajata rajataha. Rajata atyanta bhava, rajatasya atyanta bhava vat, vati ya shuktika, tasyam shuktikayam, rajatasya avabhasaha, adhyasaha. When is it seen? When the rajata samsarga is there, then alone it is seen. So swa samsrujyama rajata, rajata samsrujyamane sati, rajata atyanta bhavavati shuktikayam avabhasyatvam kasya rajatasya, rajatasya avabhasyatvam adhyasaha adhyastatvam ityartha. So that is the lakshana. When the shuktika has, or rather when the rajata has samsarga with the shukti, at that time rajata is seen where rajata isn't there. So at that time rajata isn't there in shuktika. Why this swasamsrujyamana has been mentioned, we'll see, we'll go back and see the lakshana and then see the pariksha also. But I need this word swasamsrujyamana टू लुक एट द टीका इट इज फॉरवर्ड लुकिंग बिफोर इट इंट्रोड्यूसेस तथा ही विच इज इन द रत्नप्रभा बिफोर द लक्षण सो संसृज्यमान हैज बीन यूज इन द टीका वाई दैट इज नीडेड बिकॉज इफ लेट्स से रजता somebody takes the silver and puts it in the shell that time it is not an adhyasa let's say you have silver in the pocket just imagine you are seeing silver on the seashore in a shell and then you want to make a comparison oh let me see what, did it really look like a silver you have some silver in your pocket or you are wearing some silver you take it out and put it in that shell And then you have a look. Does it appear same the way the silver appeared there? The earlier silver, when the silver wasn't there, that time it was a bhranti. It was an adhyasa. Now it is not a bhranti. When you have put the silver there. But the lakshana, if it does not have swasamsrujyamana, then it will have ativyapti in that silver also which you have placed now. Which is vyavaharika satrajata. It is not प्रातिभाषिक सदरजत सो टू अवॉइड दैट अतिव्याप्ति इन सिचुएशन वेयर सिल्वर इज देयर इन द शेल देयर कैन बी अ केस वेयर सिल्वर हैज बीन ब्रॉट एंड पुट घटा इज एंड देयर इन द ऑन द भूतल नाउ घटा इज ब्रॉट एंड पुट देयर इफ यू आर सीइंग घटा व्हेन द घटा इज ब्रॉट एंड पुट When it wasn't there, that time if you see it is a bhranti, it is an adhyasa. Therefore you can say, oh, it's an adhyasa, paratra puro drushta obhasa, smriti rupa ityadi. But then paratra obhasa, that much is the lakshana. So paratra bhutale, paratra bhutale, yatra ghatav nasti, tatra ghatav bhasa adhyasa. घटस्य अध्यास घटाध्यास सो घटाध्यास हैज टेकन प्लेस ऑन द भूतला यू आर सीइंग घटा व्हेन इट इज नॉट देयर बट देन व्हाइल यू आर सीइंग घटा समबडी ब्रिंग्स एंड पुट्स अ घटा नाउ द घटा इज बीइंग सीन दैट घटा इज नॉट अध्यास सो इन द इनिशियल मोमेंट व्हेन यू आर सीइंग घटा व्हेन इट इज देयर दैट टाइम इट इज एन अध्यास नाउ द घटा इज बीन ब्रॉट एंड पुट देयर You are seeing the ghata, that is not an adhyasa. But the adhyasa lakshana will go there. Because that paratra is still that bhutala. Where it wasn't there, paratra. Now it is there. That same paratra, you will have ghata, which is not an adhyasa anymore. It is not an artha adhyasa. So lakshana will ativyapti there. So what should you say? You should add swasamsrujyamane. When the ghata adhyasa, ghata samsrujyamana, ghata samsarga is there, that time the paratra, that time bhutala does not have ghata, when you are seeing it, that time it does not have. But when it is brought, that time there is a samsarga also of the ghata, but it is in the rightful place, yogyata is there. So anyway, swasamsrujyamana word is needed. Now that word is looked at in the tika as to paratra padatatparana tika paratra padatatparana lakshana pravishtam yat swasamsrujyamanatva visheshanam. That swasamsrujyamanatva visheshana is there in the lakshana. How so? Paratra padatatparana. When it said paratra, that samsarga is not possible if the adhyastha padartha isn't there really but still without samsarga you cannot see so samsarga is adhyastha there samsarga hai adhyastha in the adhikarana but the adhikarana idam is there in the adhyasa there is no samsarga adhyasa we have seen earlier in the adhyastha padartha the adhikarana idam Is not adhyasa because it is there. Swarupata there. Swarupa adhyasa isn't there. Samsarga adhyasa is there. In both cases, samsarga adhyasa is there. Because idam has nothing to do. Shuktika idam. Has idam amsha does not have anything to do with the rajata. So samsarga adhyasa is there. And Rajata also has nothing to do with the idam in the adhisthana. Samsarga adhyasa is there. But swarupa adhyasa, rajata swarupata isn't there. So rajata in shuktika has swarupa adhyasa also. Whereas idam is really there. Idam rajatam when you say, then idam idanta in rajata is not adhyasa. Idanta is really there, which belongs to the adhikarana, shukti. So now samsarga adhyasa has to be accepted. So samsarga is also adhyasta there. So swasamsrujya mane, when it is having a samsarga, that time swatyanta bhavavati, that time abhava should be there. So in the ghata example, when the ghata samsarga is there, ghata samsarga is there, samsarga adhyasa wise also there is a samsarga, ghata samsarga with the bhutala. And when the real ghata is brought, vyavaharika ghata is brought and kept there, that time also there is a ghata samsarga. So during the samsarga kala, is there abhava of ghata or not? In the earlier scenario, when there is no ghata and you are seeing a ghata, that time ghata abhava vati bhutale. So lakshana samanvaya is there. That time there is a swasamsrujyamane sati, at that time swa atyanta bhavati bhutale, ghata atyanta bhavavati bhutale, ghata avabhasaha ghata adhyasaha, ghata avabhasa is there. So lakshana samanvaya is there. However, in the case of ghata which is brought later and kept there, ghata samsarga is there. So ghata samsrujyamane sati, that much is true there also. But swa atyanta bhavati, is it true? Ghata atyanta bhavati, it isn't. So ghata atyanta bhava isn't there. It was there earlier, now it isn't there. Therefore lakshana samanvaya is not there in the lakshana ativyapti, isn't there, not samanvaya, it is, there is no ativyapti in the ghata which isn't which is what? Swabhavati bhutale, but paschad anitaha ghata. Later the ghata has been brought. There is no ativyapti there. Therefore, swasamsrujyamana word is needed. Now the tika says, paratra pada tatparena. In that paratra pada, tatpare is also swasamsrujyamana. Lakshana pravishtam yat swasamsrujyamanatva visheshanam. Paratra is where there is a samsarga of that which is adhyastha. Therefore, paratra. Paratra is the adhikarana. Adhikarana should have the adheya samsarga. In both cases, whether it is real or unreal, there is a pratiti. Yathartha anubha or ayathartha anubha, samsarga should be there with the adhishtana. What kind of samsarga can be discussed later? You can qualify that. You can have an avachedaka. But there is samsurjyamana. Manattvam, there is a samsarga. So yat samsrujyamanatva visheshanam tad upapadanartham padadvayam bhavati. To explain that you need other smriti rupaha. It is not really there. Samsarga of what? Of that which is smriti rupa. Smritehe swaryamanasya rupam iva rupam yasya. Ghatasya va rajatasya va. In the shukti rajatasala rajatasya adhyasattvam avabhasattvam adhyasattvam na lakshana pravishtam iti bhava. But these two words, smriti rupa and purva drushta, they do not have presence in the lakshana proper. Artharupa adhyasa paratvena prathamato lakshana yojayati tatha iti. Now artharupa adhyasa is described by karmani ghai avabhasyate iti avabhasa rajata adhyartha in ratna prava. Then tasya ayogyam adhikaranam paratra padarthaha. Tasya ayogyam adhikaranam. It is ayogya to have rajata anuhava there. Rajata jnana there. Rajata itself being there is not possible. Why? Because the adhikarana has ayogyatvam. Now, kim nama ayogyatvam? Adhikaranasya ayogyatvam. Shuktikayaha अयोग्यत्वं किम्? रजत अवभासे तस्मिन् रजत अवभासे अधिकरणस्य शुक्तिकायाः अवभास्य अधिकरणस्य अयोग्यत्वं किम्? व्हाट इज द अयोग्यत्वं देयर? नाउ अयोग्यत्वं ऑफ अधिकरण शुक्ति टू शो रजत इज इंक्वायर्ड इनटू. नाउ यू टेक एन एग्जांपल केस ऑफ घटा. घटा इजंट देयर ऑन द भूतला बट घटा इज सीन. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस घटा नॉट बीइंग देयर इन द भूतला? भूतला हैज अयोग्यत्वं टू शो घटा व्हेन घटा इजंट देयर. दैट इज ट्रू, एक्सेप्टेबल बाय एवरी दार्शनिका. हाउएवर व्हाट इज दैट अयोग्यत्वं? That varies. Puro Mimamsaka says, what is this abhava ghata bhavaha kim rupaha? What is ghata bhava? Ghata se abhavaha. What is abhava ghata bhava? Ghata bhava in the bhutala, where you say bhutalasya ayogyatvam. For ghata pratiti there. That is ghatabhava. So that is the ayogyatvam. Puro Mimamsaka says ghatabhavaha adhikarana rupaha. Adhishthana rupaha. This is what Uttar Mimamsaka also says. Vedantin, we say what is the abhava of rajata in shukti? In the shukti, what is the abhava of rajata? Rajata abhava is what? Is shukti. You see shukti there. By anupalabdhi pramana, you see there is no rajata. In the example case, ghata isn't there. How do you know ghata isn't there? Anupalabdhi pramana. What is anupalabdhi pramana? What is this abhava? We don't say ghata abhava is there. Nayayika says ghata abhava is there. When we say ghata abhava is there, ghato nasti iti vat. घटो नास्ति इति रूपः यः घटाभावः स अधिष्ठान रूपः. दैट इज अधिष्ठान रूपः, भूतल रूपः. घटाभावः इज भूतल रूपः. आई सी भूतल, आई डोंट सी घटा. सो भूतल दृष्टि दर्शन इटसेल्फ इज घटाभाव. हाउएवर घटा अभाव अभाव इज देयर इन भूतल. दिस इज द नैयायिका'स पर्सपेक्टिव. सो देशे दैट घटाभाव दृश्यते. कुत्र दृष्टते? कुत्र दृश्यते? तस्मिन् एव अधिकरणे अधिष्ठाने भूतले दृश्यते. सो घटाभाव इज सीन इन द भूतल. सो भूतल विल हैव व्हाट? घट अभाव. देयरफॉर द धर्म इन भूतल विल बी घट अभावत्वम. घट अभाववत् भूतल इज घट अभाववत्. एंड बाय मतुप घटाभाव अस्मिन् अस्ति इति घटाभाववत् अस्मिन् भूतले घटाभावः वर्तते अस्ति. देयरफॉर भूतल इज व्हाट? घटाभाववान् भूतलः. भूतलम् भूतलम्, सो न्यूटर. घटाभाववत् भूतलम्. मतुप इज एडेड. बकार इज बिकम वकार. घटाभाववत् भूतलम्. सो भूतल निष्ठ घटाभाववत्त्वम्. व्हाट विल भूतल हैव? घटाभाववत्त्वम्. नैयायिका विल से व्हाट? भूतल इज नॉट नैयायिका. पूर्व मीमांसका विल से भूतल हैज घट अभाव. डज नॉट हैव घटाभाव. घटाभाव इज भूतल. भूतल इज घटाभाव. सो दैट इज आस्क्ड हियर एज टू अयोग्यत्वम् इन द रजत बीइंग सीन नॉट इन द In the Lakshana, when you say ayogyatvam of the Shuktika to have an avabhasa of Rajata. Rajata avabhasa in Shuktika is Shuktikaya ayogyatvam. That is adhyasatvam. So ayogyatvam kim? Adhikaranasya ayogyatvam aropya atyanta bhava vatvam tadvatvam va. So if bhutala has ghata bhava, then nayayika, the way he says bhutala has ghata abhava, therefore bhutala is ghata abhava vat, therefore bhutala has ghata abhava vatvam. सो तद्वत्त्वं वा दिस इज सेकंड पक्ष इज नैयायिक पक्ष पूर्व मीमांसका सेज अधिकरण से अयोग्यत्वम आरोप्य घटा इन दी घटा केस घटा घटा इज सीन देयर इट इज आरोप्य इट इज नॉट देयर रियली भ्रम घटा इट इज आरोप्य आरोप्य अत्यंत अभाव इज देयर अत्यंत अभाव इज व्हाट नैयायिका सेज सो अत्यंत अभावत्वम भूतल इज घटाभाव रूप देयरफॉर घट अभाव इज भूतल सो भूतल विल हैव व्हाट तस्य भाव घटाभावस्य भाव सो घटाभावत्वम भूतले घटाभावत्वम इज पूर्व मीमांसका अयोग्यत्वम भूतल टू हैव घट प्रतीति वेर घट इज इन देयर नाउ नैयायिका सेज इट इज घटाभाववत्वम दैट धर्म इज देयर इन भूतल सो घटाभावत्वम घटाभाववत्वम दैट इज द डिफरेंस सिमिलरली इन द शुक्ति रजता स्थल शुक्तिका हैज रजता भाव इज व्हाट नैयायिका सेज पूर्व मीमांसका सेज शुक्तिका इटसेल्फ इज रजता भाव मीनिंग रजता भाव अध्यासस्य अधिष्ठान रूपत्वम सो रजता इज व्हाट अधिष्ठान रूप इट इज रियली शुक्तिका देयर इज नो रजता एट ऑल सो रजता अभाव इज शुक्तिका रूप दैट इज व्हाई व्हेन यू हैव अधिष्ठान निगेशन सॉरी नॉट अधिष्ठान द आरोप्य निगेशन आरोप्य इज अध्यस्थ व्हेन यू से इदं रजतम एंड देन when the rajata is not seen to be there in adhishtana then you say idam kim so you say iyam shuktika natu rajatam so rajata is negated when rajata is negated what is it negated by iyam shuktika so that idanta is associated with shuktika which is adhishtana so adhishtana rupam नतु रजतम रजतम नास्ति रजत अभाव इज व्हाट शुक्तिकायाः प्रतीति सो शुक्तिका रूप अभाव इज ऑफ अध्यस्त आरोप्य इज अधिष्ठान रूप एंड देयरफॉर अत्यंत अभावत्वम ओनली नॉट अत्यंत भाववत्वम अत्यंत भावत्वम दिस पूर्व मीमांसका सो दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन टीका आरोप्य आरोप्य इज रजत आरोप्य इति अभावस्य अधिकरण स्वरूपत्वम् इति मतम अवलंब्य दिस इज मीमांसका मतम इति मतम अवलंब्य इदमुक्तम् इति भावः सो मीमांसका मत अनंगीकार मतम अनंगीकारी मतम इज पूर्व मीमांसका मत इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल टू नैयायिका देयर बाय द सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज बीन आस्क्ड अनंगीकार मतम अवलंब्य आरोप्य अत्यंताभाववत्वम् अनंगीकार मतम अवलंब्य आरोप्य रजत अत्यंताभाववत्वम् अयोग्यत्वम् इति निर्वक्ति तद्वत्त्वम् वा इति सो नैयायिक पक्ष इज मेंशन्ड देयर परत्र औभास इति पदद्वयेन परिष्कृतं व्यावर्तक लक्षणम् आह सो परत्र औभासः दिस इज द लक्षण ऑफ अध्यास इति पदद्वयेन परिष्कृतं व्यावर्तक लक्षणं आह तथा च सो दिस इज आल्सो व्यावर्तक लक्षण हाउ सो तथा च एकावच्छेदन स्वसंसृज्यमाने इति रत्नप्रभा तथा च एकावच्छेदन स्वसंसृज्यमाने स्वात्यंताभाववति अवभास्यत्वं अध्यस्तत्वं इत्यर्थः सो देयर शुड इट शुड व्यावर्तक इतर व्यावर्तक इट शुड बी देयर देयर विल बी अतिव्याप्ति अदरवाइज नाउ तथा च एकावच्छेदन स्वसंसृज्यमाने स्वात्यंताभाववति अवभास्यत्वं अध्यस्तत्वं स्वसंसृज्यमाने वी सॉ व्हाट इज एकावच्छेदेन व्हाट इज दिस स्वात्यंताभाववति ऑल दिस परीक्षा हैज टू बी डन नाउ इदं च साध्यनादि अध्यास साधारण लक्षणं सो दिस अध्यास लक्षण इज कॉमन टू सादि अध्यास एज वेल एज अनादि अध्यास सादि अनादि अविद्या is anadi its karya is adhyasa the entire prapancha ahankaradi prapancha All that is adhyasa, arthadhyasa. That adhyasa is what? It is anadi adhyasa. When did we start taking ourselves to be human beings or any antakkarana with the antakkarana dharma, sharira dharma? We have always been doing so. So it is anadi. Whereas there are some adi adhyasas. So something that you see somewhere where it isn't there. Or let's say something is being seen, ghata is being seen, ghata is taken away, you still see there. So there is adhyasa which has a beginning and an end also. It will end. But it is sadhi. Unlike prapancha, ahankaradi prapancha, which is anadi adhyasa. However, this lakshana is common to both. So that is not specifically for one type of adhyasa, it includes both. Idam cha sadhyanadi adhyasa sadharanam lakshanam. Sanyoge ati vyapti nirasaya ekavachedana iti. This ekavachedana shabda, why do you need? Why not say swasamsurjamane swatyanta bhavati avabhasyatvam adhyasatvam? Why not say so? Why do you need ekavachedana? The avachedaka should be the same. That is what is being mentioned. Swasamsurjamane sati, when there is ghata samsarga in the bhutala. Another example is taken here. So why ekavachedena? Sanyogi ati vyapti varanaya. Nirasaya. Nirasaya is varanaya. So sanyogi ati vyapti. Sanyoga. The example given there is vruksha. On the vruksha, there is a kapi. There is a monkey sitting on the tree. This is an example from the Tarka Sangraha. Tarka Sangraha Tikas. So there is vruksha. On vruksha, there is a kapi. So kapi vruksha sanyoga asti. If you say kapi vruksha sanyoga is there, it's a fact. But where are you looking at? Where is the monkey sitting? Monkey is not sitting at the base of the tree. The monkey is sitting on the branch of the tree or the upward, it is sitting on the upper part of the tree. So agra bhage kapi asti, mule kapi nasti. So mule kapi nasti, agra bhage asti. So agra bhaga is avachedaka now. Mula bhage is avachedaka of vruksha. So sanyoga being there, kapi vruksha sanyoga is there. Where is it there? Kapi vruksha sanyoga is there with the avachedaka of agra bhaga. So agra avachedena vrukshe kapi sanyoga vartate. Mula avachedena vrukshe kapi sanyoga nasti. There is no sanyoga of kapi at the bottom of the tree. The monkey is not sitting at the bottom of the tree, so there is no sanyoga there. The sanyoga is at the upper portion. Now this sanyoga ati vyapti nirasaya. If you say swasamsurjyamane swatyanta bhavati, when you look at the mula of the vruksha, their swa is what is seen there. The monkey is seen. However, the monkey is not seen at the root. Is seen. So on the root of the tree, the monkey isn't there. But if you say vruksha sanyoga is there, if you say vruksha sanyoga is there, if you just say vruksha sanyoga is there, you are not using avachedaka. But swasamsurjyamane, when you say swasamsurjyamane kapi samsurjyamane vrukshe swatyanta bhavavati, there is also atyanta bhava at the root of the tree. Swasamsurjyamane is there at the top of the tree. Kapis samsrujyamane vrukshe samsrujyamane sati. When in that vruksha and samsrujyamane are not in samanadi karanyam. So we'll say vrukshe first. In the vruksha vishaye, vruksha sanyoge, in that vishaya there is ati vyapti of this lakshana. How so? Swasamsrujyamane kapi samsrujyamane swatyanta bhavati vrukshe avabhasyatvam kapyavabhasyatvam adhyasthatvam. Does the lakshana apply there? Samanvaya is there. Why? Because swasamsrujyamane, the kapi is there. Right now the monkey is sitting on the tree, therefore there is a samyoga with the tree. So samsarujyamanatvam is there. So atyantabhava is also there, because at the root of the tree there is svatyantabhava also. Kapi atyantabhava is also there. Where kapi atyantabhava is there, and when the samsarga is there, that time the kapi avabhasa is there. Kapi is seen. That avabhasyatvam is what? Adhyastatvam. Is it adhyasa? It is not adhyasa. But the lakshana is overreaching there, therefore is ativyapti. So sanyogi ativyapti nirasa ekavachedana. If you say ekavacheda, if you use ekavacheda, what is the fact there in the sanyoga stala of kapi vriksha sanyoga? If you add avachedaka, you say agra avachedana. So what is that is explained here further. Sanyogasya swasamsrujyamane vrikshe. When there is sanyoga, sanyogasya swasamsrujyamane. So there sanyoga should be taken, not swa is sanyoga. Kapi vriksha sanyoga samsrujyamana. So kapi, not kapi samsrujyamane, sanyoga is there. Sanyoga samsrujyamane vrikshe. In the vriksha there is sanyoga. So at that time when there is sanyoga, sanyoga of what? Kapi vriksha sanyoga. So kapi vriksha sanyoga is there in the vriksha also, because sanyoga will be there in both. Whichever are there in the sanyoga, if there is a hasta and vriksha sanyoga, the sanyoga will be there in a dharma, in hasta also and in vriksha also. Similarly, kapi vriksha sanyoga is there. So kapi vriksha sanyoga is a dharma which will be there in kapi also and in vriksha also. So in this vriksha, sanyogasya samsrujyamane vrikshe, in that vriksha where there is sanyoga present, and when it is present, swatyanta bhava, sanyoga atyanta bhava is also there at the moola of the vriksha. There is no kapi vriksha sanyoga at the moola of the vriksha. So swatyanta bhavati avabhasyatve, sanyogasya avabhasya is there, bhasyatvam is there, because kapi vriksha sanyoga is there. Is it there in the vriksha? Yes, it is on the vriksha. Then even then tatra api स्वस्वात्यंता भावयोर मूलाग्रावच्छेदक भेदात नति व्याप्ति. How will एकावच्छेदन दिस पदा, how will it take अतिव्याप्ति अवे? When you say एकावच्छेदन, then अवच्छेदकत्वम cannot be अग्रभागा for the कपिवृक्ष संयोग, and for कपिवृक्ष संयोग अभाव you cannot have another अवच्छेदक of मूला. So there ativyapti nirasa is done. In tarka sangraha tikas, if you see, you will have avachedaka. So in deepika you see agra avachedakena. Here it is seen as to swa atyanta bhava. So sanyoga and sanyoga atyanta bhava yor bheda katham. How is the bheda? Moola agra avachedaka bhedat. Moola, so swa sanyoga is there, and atyanta bhava of sanyoga is also there. Agra avachedakena vruksha, agra avachedaka, if you add agra avachedena moole, agra avachedena agra bhage, agra avacheda kapi vruksha sanyoga asti. However, swa atyanta bhava, sanyoga atyanta bhava, how is it there? By moola avachedena, moola avacheda, by moola avacheda there is absence of kapi vriksha sanyoga at the bottom of the tree. So you have avachedakas, the top part or the bottom part. The branch is the avachedaka, the top part, and the root or the moola is the avachedaka for the bottom part. Therefore you can explain both kapi vriksha sanyoga also and kapi vriksha sanyoga abhava also. So abhavavati sanyoga abhavati sanyoga, that is paratra avabhasa, there will be ativyapti. But if you add avachedaka, there avachedakas are different. Agravachedena kapi vriksha sanyoga asti, moolavachedena kapi vriksha sanyoga nasti. Once you say ekavachedena, then you don't have a choice. You tell me, is there kapi vriksha sanyoga as well as abhava using the same avacheda? You can use agra or moola, then there is no ativyapti, then there is no avabhasyatvam. देन इफ देर इज अवभाष्यत्वम एट दि अग्र देन अग्रावच्छेदेन कपिवृक्ष संयोग अवभाष्यत्वम इज ओनली देर एंड बट देर इज नो अभावती वृक्ष हैज संयोग सो देर इज नो स्वाभावती संयोग अभावती कपिवृक्ष संयोगस्य दर्शनम नास्ति अवभाष्यत्वम नास्ति अग्रभागे सो अग्रावच्छेदने इफ यू से देन यू कैन नॉट हैव मूल अवच्छेदक इफ यू से आई विल टेक मूल अवच्छेदक देन वी विल से ओ यस अभाव इज डेफिनेटली देर बट देर इज नो कपिवृक्ष संयोग अवभाष्यत्वम मूलावच्छेदेन कपिवृक्ष मूलावच्छेदेन स्वसंसृज्यमाने स्वात्यंता भाववती अभाव इज देर बट स्वसंसृज्यमान इज नॉट देर यू डोंट हैव संयोग ऑफ कपिवृक्ष इन द मूल सो देर इज नो अवभासा देर सच अवभासा इज नॉट देर देयरफॉर अतिव्याप्ति निराशा टेक्स प्लेस देर इज नो अतिव्याप्ति देर न अतिव्याप्ति ही बिकॉज भेद इज देर अवच्छेदक भेद इज देर अवच्छेदक इज नॉट वन देर फॉर एकावच्छेदेन वर्ड इज नेसेसिटेटेड टू टेक अवे अध्यास लक्षण अतिव्याप्ति इन संयोग स्थल संयोग टीका अध्यस्तत्वम् अर्थरूपाध्यास अध्यस्तत्वम् इत्यर्थ आत्मत्वावच्छेदेन आत्मनि अहंकारस्य संसर्गकाले तस्य कल्पितत्वेन तदत्यन्ताभाव अस्ति तस्माद् अहम् इत्याकारके प्राथमिके अहंकाररूपार्थाध्यासे लक्षणसमन्वयः सो इन दि एक्सेम्प्लिफाइड हियर वी हैव फॉर दि example of the bhashya we are taking shukti rajata where bhashya is also taking shukti rajata or raju sarpa which is an example to explain the exemplified which is yushmad asmat adhyasa on each other arthadhyasa here and to explain the shukti rajata we are taking the example of others to explain that also we are taking others Here what is being done is that Lakshana Samanvaya is seen in the example. So Ativyapti, to show Ativyapti, Nirasa, we are taking other examples of Sanyoga also. Kapivriksha Sanyoga. Then once it is established in the Lakshana, Raju Sarpa or Lakshana is established in the targeted example, which is Target example, rather example, which is going to be finally show you that there is adhyasa in the exemplified also. This kind of lakshana samanvaya is there in the atma anatma sthala also. Now what is being done is that exemplified, which is the moola tatpare vishaya, which is the adhyasa bhashya tatpare vishaya, atma anatma adhyasa. There it is. Extended this lakshana is explained the lakshana samanvaya is being done adhyastatvam not adhyas atma atmatva avachhedena ekavachhedena atmatva avachhedena you are not switching this avachhedaka atmatva is only one avachheda avachhedaka atmatva avachhedena atmani ahankarasya samsarga kale samsamsurjyamane tasya आत्मनः कल्पितत्वेन सॉरी अहंकारस्य संसर्गकाले तस्य कल्पितत्वेन आत्मनि अहंकारस्य कल्पितत्वेन तस्य अहंकारस्य कल्पितत्वेन दट अवभास्यत्वम् इज व्हाट कल्पितत्वम् बिकॉज इट इज इन देयर परत्र इट इज नॉट देयर इन आत्मा अहंकारस्य संसर्गकाले स्वसंसृज्यमाने तस्यैव अहंकारस्य कल्पितत्वेन तदत्यन्ता भावः अस्ति आत्मनि अहंकारस्य अत्यन्ता भावः अस्ति तस्माद् अहम् इत्याकारके व्हेन यू से अहम् विच वाज शोन एज अहम् इदं मम इदं इति अध्यास दैट अहम् मम देयर अहम् इज टेकन अहम् इत्याकारके प्राथमिके दिस इज द फर्स्ट अध्यास अहंकार रूपार्थाध्यासे लक्षण समन्वयः सो अहंकारादि प्रतीति अहम् प्रतीति इन आत्मा अहम् मनुष्यः लेटर दैट प्रतीति ऑफ अहंकार अहम अहम इज व्हाट अहंकार अहंकार प्रतीति इन आत्मा इज एन अध्यास एवं स्वयं इत्यत्र स्वयंत्वावच्छेदेन प्रत्यगात्मनि कूटस्थे अहंकारादे संसर्ग काले तदत्यंताभावस्य सत्वात् कूटस्थ कल्पित अहंकाराद्यर्थरूपाध्यासे लक्ष्ये समन्वय लक्षण समन्वय. सिमिलरली यू फ्लिप दि संसर्ग काल इन दि संसर्ग काल दिस वाज संसर्ज्यमाने अगेन स्वयं इत्यत्र स्वयंत्वावच्छेदेन एक अवच्छेद अगेन दि फ्लिप साइड प्रत्यगात्मनि कूटस्थे अहंकारादे संसर्गा काले तदत्यंताभावस्य सत्वा देर इज एन अत्यंताभाव इफ यू टेक बोथ साइड्स आल्सो इन आत्मा अहंकार इज नॉट देर अत्यंताभाव इज देर एंड इन अहंकार आत्मा इज डेफिनेटली नॉट देर संसर्ग इज इन देर thereby संसर्ग काले तदत्यंता भावस्य सत्वात् कूटस्थ कल्पित अहंकाराद्यर्थ रूपाध्यासे कूटस्थत्वम् इन अहंकार दैट इज भ्रांति संसर्ग इज भ्रांति देयर की लक्ष्ये लक्षण समन्वय साधित्वम् जन्यत्वम् व्हाट इज साधित्वम् जन्यत्वम् व्हाट हैज अ बिगिनिंग व्हाट इज बॉर्न इन टाइम इज साधि सो सादित्वम जन्यत्वम अनादित्वम अजन्यत्वम एंड सिमिलरली अनादि अनादि अध्यास अहंकारादि अध्यास इज ऑल अनादि बिकॉज इट इज अजन्य इट हैज ऑलवेज बीन देयर इट हैज नॉट कम अप इन टाइम अहंकाराध्यास सादिहि अविद्या चित्संबंधाध्यासो अनादिरिति भावः. सो व्हाट इज द डिविजन हियर व्हिच इज सादि व्हिच इज अनादि इन द एग्जांपलिफाइड अहंकाराध्यास सादिहि अहंकार अध्यास ऑल्दो इट इज सीन एज अनादि इट इज प्रवाह अनादित्वम प्रवाह नित्यत्वम नित्यत्वम इन सेंस टिल अनादित्वम नॉट नित्यत्वम नित्यत्वम मींस इट विल नॉट गो अवे एवर बट इट विल गो अवे इट इज अंतवत. हाउएवर इन द एग्जांपलिफाइड ऑल्दो वी से अहंकारादि प्रपंच इज अनादि एज वेल इट इज प्रवाह नित्यत्वम. व्हेन डिड वी हैव अविद्या वी ऑलवेज हैड अविद्या व्हाट अबाउट अविद्या कार्य एसोसिएशन इट टेक्स प्लेस इन जन्म व्हेन द शरीर is born then there is ahankara adhyasa which is perceived there in the sharira also sharira is also superimposed on oneself where antakarana is already superimposed on oneself adhyasta but since antakarana goes in bija roopa at the end of kalpa sharira is destroyed anyway stura sharira but sukshma sharira continues to be there in seed form even after kalpa therefore we also talk about anadityam but आदित्वम आल्सो वी टॉक अबाउट बिकॉज़ जन्म इज आल्सो आदित्वम बट अहंकार संबंध एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द कल्पा इज आल्सो मैनिफेस्टेशन फ्रॉम द सीड फॉर्म इनटू द फुल्ली मैनिफेस्ट अंतकरण विच हैज ट्रेवल इन डिफरेंट लोकास देयर द कनेक्शन इज देयर द सेम जीवा इज जीवात्मा इज कनेक्टेड विद द सेम अंतकरण फॉर द कर्म फल व्यवस्था टू बी वैलिड and therefore in fact the association itself makes him a jiva but avidya association makes him a jiva makes the entity him or her through manifestation in a stula sharira vaya sukshma sharira although the jiva pullinga jiva not literally he or she but pullinga jiva shabda pullinga shabda jiva is used only when atma is associated with avidya Brahma is associated with avidya and that avidya karya association is antakarana ahankaradi association that has to be seen as sadhi because it is not there across kalpas it is in bija roopa avidya association alone is there karya association isn't there antakarana is not manifest similarly antakarana is not clearly manifest unless stula sharira is there Therefore, also Adityam should be seen across janmas or at least across kalpas. So, ahankara adhyasa sadhihi. Whereas, avidya chit sambandha, avidya brahma, brahmatma sambandha is also there. It is anadi, ever been there. Although, the karya sambandha is only when karya is manifest, therefore adimat, but then The avidya chit sambandha has always been there. Avidya chit sambandha adhyasaha anadi. That is also adhyasa, but it is anadi adhyasa iti bhava taduktam. And it's a well-known shloka here. Jivesho vishuddha chit tatha jivesho urbhida avidya tachito yogaha shadasmakam anadeha iti. We accept six anadis, which are those jiva is anadi, isha ishvara is anadi, vishuddha chit brahma, shuddha brahma, parabrahma, nirguna brahma is anadi. Three are these anadis. Then jiva ishvara bhida. Jiva and ishvara are not two, they are one, but still there is a bheda. Bheda pratiti is there. How long has this bheda pratiti been there? It has been there forever. Therefore, jiveshwar bheda. Bheda is also anadi, fourth anadi. Avidya is fifth anadi. Avidya has also been there. It has not come in time. Otherwise, moksha, nirmoksha prasanga. Moksha will be impossible. Tat chito yoga. Avidya and chit also have yoga. Just like jiva and isha have bheda. That is because of avidya really. So avidya is there. Avidya has to be accepted as anadi. Tat chit aur yoga, avidya and chit yoga. How long has been Brahma, Brahmatma, Chaitanya been associated with avidya? Always been there. Therefore, sixth anadi. Chadasmakam anadayaha iti. We'll look at more in the next part. We are already at 7:20. I'm sorry. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरी सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. I have an alarm here for when I have the next paṭha. Today I don't have that next paṭha. I switched off the alarm, so I didn't recollect. I didn't see at the time. Namaste.
Namaste.